6:39 on New Jersey 101.5. Good morning. I'm Bill Spadea with you at 10 o'clock this morning, talking Jersey, taking your calls 1-800-283-101.5. So I want to ask you, you know, we have this whole statement out there today. You get it from politicians will tell you, law enforcement will tell you, see something, say something. So I get to the airport and I'm at Terminal B in the international arrivals at Newark Airport. And I've got a few minutes, you know, the plane lands and I know she's got to get through customs and the whole thing. So my daughter's back from London and I'm waiting in the international arrivals. It's like a lobby there. Excuse me. And so I sit down, there's a back row of seats and I sit down, there's an empty seat to my right. And then a woman sitting and you know, I'm sipping a cup of coffee. I'm hanging out and a guy comes over and he's clearly a limo driver or a cab driver. He's got a sign with the person he's picking up. And he looks at the woman next to me and says, "Hey, is that your package?" And she looked at him and said, "No, actually, I didn't even notice that until you pointed it out." So there was a bag sitting on the floor. And, you know, he kind of had that look like, you know, somebody left a bag. Like you hear about, don't leave your bags unattended. Somebody's going to get it. So a couple minutes go by and then one of the women that worked there with the red jackets, and I don't know if they're just there they're not security, but they're there to just facilitate to make sure you get your bag and everything else. So she comes over, asks the same question, looks at her, says, "Hey, is that your bag?" "No, not my bag. Didn't even notice it till this guy just pointed it out." Looked at me. "Is it your bag?" "Nope, not my bag." So all right, now it's been like 5 or 6 minutes. A second red jacketed person comes over. So now this is the Newark staff. So now you got the limo guy with the sign and two Newark Liberty Airport staffers. And the two staffers, guy comes over, same question. Now it's a third time. Looks at the woman next to me and me. "Is that your bag?" Nope, not our bag. "Not my bag." So now it's getting a little awkward. So the woman next to me makes a joke. Now, I was surprised she said it. It's so funny. We're so politically correct today. She's like, "You know, if that's a bomb, we're probably not even going to know it because we're so close to it." Eric, this happened, right? This is the joke she makes. So I'm like, oh, okay, awkward. So now the two staffers, the two red jacketed staffers, start arguing over whose responsibility the bag is. "No, you get the bag." No, you get the bag. So they walk away. So again, back to the woman, me, and the guy with the sign. Now the guy with the sign, I don't know if he heard her joke or not about the bomb. So he walks away. So he just kind of like, okay, that's a good point actually. Maybe I don't want to be standing here. And so now I'm going to say at least 5 minutes go by. Felt longer because I'm waiting, and now I'm like, all right, come on, you know, it's got to get through customs. I'm ready to go home. It's getting late. The guy with the red jacket, the Newark Airport staffer, walks back over with one of the signs from the bathroom that says wet floor. Caution, wet floor. Puts the wet floor sign next to the bag. So this is the solution at Newark Liberty Airport to an unattended package. All right. So a couple minutes go by. He walks away. About 3 minutes later, the woman, the other red jacketed, you know, again, I don't know officially what their title is, but they work at the airport. She walks back over with the metal stanchion, that looks like a Festivus pole, you know, that hold up the divider so that when you're walking in line, they can control traffic. Nothing attached to it. Boom, puts it right down. So now I'm taking pictures of this. Now, I have not posted these pictures because I'm not sure what you're allowed and not allowed to do in terms of taking pictures at an airport. I'll ask Eric that when he comes back. I'm going to have to find, I need a ruling on that before I post it. So because I'm fascinated now. Now I'm like, all right, how are they going to deal with the unattended package? So now you got the caution wet floor, you got the stanchion, and the bag is still sitting there. So a couple minutes go by. The guy who put the original, the sign down that said wet floor, you know what I'm talking about, it's like a triangle and it's yellow. He comes back with a second stanchion. So we're now collecting things around the bag. And I look at the woman next to me and I said, you know, I'm waiting for the caution tape. Sure enough, on the fourth trip back, he gets the yellow tape, puts that in between the stanchions. And now I've got two stanchions, a caution tape, and a wet floor sign all around an unattended package. No law enforcement, nothing. Nothing. So now, I don't know who's the dummy. Like, I kept sitting there, and I'm looking at the woman. We're kind of looking like, this is odd. So I get up, and now I'm taking pictures. I'm like, I'm not going to tweet it because you never know. So all this takes place over a 15-minute period. The final thing happens. A cop walks over. He looks, kind of looks at us, and I just shake my head no. Like, yep, that ain't mine. He picks the bag up, and he starts looking through it. Now, while this is happening, the woman cleaning the floor, there's somebody cleaning the floor, comes by with a mop. And the first attendant, the guy with the red jacket, said, hey, listen, do not clean here. Clean everywhere else, just not here. So it's like a scene happening around this bag. So now the police officer puts on his gloves. He goes through it. Turns out, it's a bag with two head pillows in it. So somebody probably bought the head pillows and then dropped it anyway. So here's my question to you. I don't even know how it ended, because at that point I looked and I'm like, all right, the traffic's starting to come out, so I'm going to go get my daughter. But what are you supposed to do with that? Like, what good is the rule of an unattended package if the solution is a wet caution, wet floor sign? I don't know if we are over paranoid in America in terms of our airports, or if we are woefully underprepared. So to wrap it up, what's funny is I'm walking out and I say goodbye to the woman on the walkout. And my daughter's with me. I'm like, hey, goodbye. And she kind of looks at me a little like, how do you know her? Like, what? So I haven't told her the story yet. My daughter turns around and she waves goodbye. Not to the woman I was talking to, somebody else. And I look at him like, would you make a friend? You know, she's like, what, did you make a friend? So this was welcome home, Elizabeth.